Hello students, in this video we will study about fundamental features which are used as a basis of animal classification. So here we start. There are several fundamental features common to various individuals. These features are the basis of animal classification. It includes, first is level of body organization. Animals possess different level of body organization. They may possess cellular level of body organization, tissue level of body organization, organ level of body organization, or organ system level of body organization. Second fundamental feature which is used as a basis of classification is pattern of complexities of various organ system like digestive system, circulatory system, or reproductive system. Next is body symmetry. Animals may be asymmetrical, radially symmetrical, or bilaterally symmetrical. Next is germ layers. Animals may be diploblastic or triploblastic. Next fundamental feature is nature of their body cavity. Animals may be acoelomate, they may be pseudocoelomate or true coelomate. Next fundamental feature is body segmentation. And last fundamental feature which is used as basis of classification is the presence or absence of notochord. First, we start with level of organization. Cells are the building block of body of all living organisms. Cell organized in definite pattern to form tissues. Many tissues organized to form organ, and many organs function together to form an organ systems. All members of animals do not exhibit the same pattern of organization of cells. They may possess cellular level of body organization, or tissue level of body organization, or organ level of body organization, or organ system level of body organization. Here we start with cellular level of body organization. Cells are loosely arranged, but they are not form any tissue. In cellular level of body organization, tissues are not found. This level is exhibited by poriferans. Second is tissue level of body organization. Some specialized cell organized to perform common function is called as tissue. This organization level is present in cylindrates and tenophores. Third level of body organization is organ level of body organization. When tissues are grouped together to form organ, this level is called organ level of body organization. Organ level of body organization exhibited by platyhelminths. Last is organ system level of body organization. In higher animals, organs are associated to form organ system, which concerned with a specific physiological function. For example, stomach, intestine, gallbladder, liver, etc. unite to form digestive system that concerned with digestion of food. Organ system level of body organization is exhibited by Esclehelmins to chordates. Second fundamental feature which is used as a basis of classification is pattern of complexities of various organ system. Organ and organ system levels begin in lower animals like platyhelminths and Esclehelmins, but complexities kept on increasing from lower to higher phyla. These complexities are the basis of classification. First, we're taking an example of digestive system. It may be of two types: incomplete digestive system or complete digestive system. If digestive system possesses only single opening toward outside which serves as both mouth and anus, it is called incomplete digestive system. Incomplete digestive system is present in cylindrates, tenophores, and platyhelminths. Next is complete digestive system. In this system, there are two openings, one for taking food and other for exit of waste. That means they possess both mouth and anus. For example, Esclehelmins to chordate all possess complete digestive system. Next is circulatory system. It may be of two types, open circulatory system or closed type of circulatory system. In open type of circulatory system, blood pump out of the heart in open spaces called sinuses. Hence, there is a direct contact and exchange of material between the blood and body cells. For example, open type of circulatory system is present in orthopods and most of the mollusks. closed type of circulatory system. In this type, blood pump out of the heart through various blood vessels like arteries, arterioles, veins, without even come in contact with body cells. Their example includes annelids, some mollusks and chordates. Next is reproductive system. Lower animals like sponges, coelenterates undergoes asexual reproduction along with the sexual reproduction, while in higher animals, sexual reproduction becomes the predominating mode of reproduction. The complexity in the structure of reproductive organ keeps on increasing from lower to higher phyla. Next organ system is excretory system. It expels the nitrogenous waste like ammonia, urea, uric acid, etc. outside the body to maintain homeostasis inside the body. Depending upon the nature of the main nitrogenous waste, animals are of following types. First is ammonotelic animals. These animals whose main nitrogenous waste is ammonia are called ammonotelic animals. For example, it is found in aquatic animals like sponges, coelenterates, ctenophores, crustaceans, echinoderms, and bony fishes. Next is ureotelic animals. Their main nitrogenous waste is urea. For example, amphibians, mammalians, and cartilaginous fishes. Next is uricotelic animals. Those animals whose main nitrogenous waste is uric acid is called uricotelic animals. Their example includes reptiles, birds, and insects. Thank you.